Allow the words to be taught and preached. Be words from you. That you allow us to receive it. We pray if there's anybody among us right now that is in need of a healing, spiritually, physically, emotionally, that you'll give it to them right now in the name of Jesus. We pray for breakthrough right now in the name of Jesus. Sometimes we're in our own individual wilderness, going round and round and round, and the promised land is right next door. Bless us this morning with breakthrough. May you give us a word on high that can point us in the right direction. For it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, for this morning's Sunday school lesson, y'all come on and welcome Unc.
All right, y'all, let's first of all, I want to thank my Lord Jesus Christ, my Savior, first and foremost. Without him, nothing, this ain't possible. I just want to say, last week when Minister Brandon had the men in a little meeting, and then he says he was giving out, the assignments, to the men. So he gave me Sunday, the 24th, to do a sermon, Bible study. So I asked him, I said, what do you want me to, teach? He said, well, let's leave it up to the Holy Spirit and let him guide you. So I said, since when we had it, I went home, I kept thinking, I said, man, what I'm going to do, So I'm flipping through the men's request, God book that they gave us, and I'm flipping in, and I'm thinking, I said, man, what should I, try to teach, I wanted to do something different, So what I did was I went through the bulletins, and just a brief, what some of them were saying, I said, on October 3rd, it said this one was accepting Christ. And they was talking about that. And then September 19th, the Bible, life-changing church, was talking about, you got it. And then, let's see, a couple more here. On January 26th of 20, the life-changing Sunday school was, lies. So that's just a few. So I decided to talk about which all of us like to do is dance. You see what I'm saying? So I asked my wife, she said, then they said, it's something different. So I went and I'm flipping through it. So, and I found it. It says dancing. I know my sister-in-law love to jam, my wife like to jam, my daughter like to jam. We all like to dance. Y'all know I love to dance. So, and it's just a coincidence, the Bible study has something about dance. Right? And I was thinking, I said, man, dancing for God? I'm like, because there's all kind of dances. Y'all know that, Y'all know what I'm talking about. You got the ones on the pole and all that, the whole nine. Yeah, y'all know what I'm talking about. I'm not going to get into no details. But it's good dancing, There is such thing as good dancing, so. And let me start off with a little bit of prayer, though. Let's start off with that. Let's all hearts and minds are clear. Let's look to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we come to you. Thank you. One more time for waking us up. Thank you, Lord, for the saints being here gathered today, Lord, and the ones on the way, Lord. And I ask that, I ask you, Lord, for special prayer for Irie, my daughter, Lord, as she, tweak her wrist, Lord, but I know you will heal her. And thank you for Lala that's feeling a lot better, Lord, and anybody else that's in our congregation sick, may you heal them. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. All right, so here we go. Dancing, all right? I'm going to start out right here. This says, dancing is spoken in the Bible as a symbol of rejoicing. So that's good right there. Dancing was a part of Egypt religious ceremonies in the biblical time. For the most part, women did the dancing, and males or females summoned and intermingled. In the early periods of Judge, the virgin of Shiloh danced as a part of the religious festivals. So what I did was I said, see Judge 21:19-23. So let me I just did a little extra for that, and it reads, I'm not going to read it all, but it says Judge 21:19. If y'all got your Bibles open, it's fine. If it's not, I'll just read it out. Then they thought of the annual festival of the Lord held in Samaria. What's that word again, babe? Shiloh, south of Lebanon, and the north of Bethia, Bethan, and along the east side of the road that goes from Bethia to Then they told the men of Benjamin, who still needed wives, go and hide in the vineyard. When you see the young woman of Shiloh come out from their dance and rush out from the vineyard, and each of them will take one of them home to the land of Benjamin to be your wife. I don't understand what that has to do with dancing, but that's what it cross reference to. I ain't understand that one. So I'm gonna keep on reading. All right. Where was I? All right. Dancing was also for festivals, amusement parks, from any religion ceremony. See Jeremiah 31:14-3. And I'll go to that real quick. Jeremiah 31:4. And it reads, I will build you my virgin Israel. You will again be happy and dance, whirling with your tambourines. So everything so far, what it's telling us, the dancing is a good thing for the Lord. You know, one that says, you hide in the bushes, see the wife, and then you take a wife if you want. And they said that the festivals, they celebrate, with dance, which is a good thing, because dancing is a physical thing to keep you in shape. All right, and proceed. Anybody would like to read, you're more than welcome to jump in. And that'd be good.
There is a time and place in every person's life for everything, including a time to dance. Coming from Ecclesiastes 3:1-8, this 28 seasons of life. To everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace.
Amen. All right. Well, see, wow. See, we think that dancing don't, you know, has a lot of avenues, but apparently that scripture right there tells you that it does. You know, dance can do a lot of things. You know, I mean, it can make you laugh, can make you cry, make you happy. It can even make you lose weight. You know what I'm saying? And so dancing is a good thing. All right, let me read on. All right, David praised God for turning his grief and mourning into dancing and praising God. And that right there says it all. You know what I mean? David knew dancing and it pleased to God. So it don't take much to please our God. You know what I mean? Because why? Because it's a good thing. It's not a bad thing. Thou have turned for me my mourning into dancing. Thou have put off my sackcloth and grind me. What was it? Girded me with gladness. I don't understand. I don't know what that word means. Okay. Thank you. All right. The next one. Praising God through leaping and dancing was an approved form of praising God according to the Bible. And that's good. See, so even though you're dancing, you're praising God, you know, it says it right in the Bible. But again, all depends what kind of dance we're talking about. Right? You got to keep that in mind. You know, that's what we got to focus on. And then it goes says in Acts chapter 3, verse 6 and 9, Peter and John was going into the temple to pray when they came across a man lame from birth. As Christ had previously taught him to do it, they said to the man, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. In verse 6. Then Peter took him by the right hand and lifted him up. Immediately his feet and ankles, and ankle bones were strong. He leaped up and walked with Peter and John into the temple, giving them glory to God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. In verse 9. So I don't know what that had to do with dancing, because they didn't mention anything he was dancing when he got up. Maybe y'all can elaborate on that, but I can't figure that one out. But maybe y'all can figure it out and let me know. But I don't understand the two similarities. You understand what I'm saying? So, all right. Before Satan distorted, dancing used to be sacred in the eyes of the Lord. All right. And 2 Samuel 6:14-16, David danced before the Lord with all his might. But see, that's another thing I don't understand. As pastor and minister, you know, always talk about the Bible, about David, about Paul, about Saul, all the things they did for God. Not once I ever heard him say that David danced for God. Yeah, see, I didn't know that. So, dancing is good. That's what I'm saying. Dancing is good.
So,
there you go. All right.
Amen.
Now, we're on the same page now. We're on the same page. Good, good. I was hoping to get a little excitement, you know what I mean? So, all right, where was I? Before I said anything, all right. Somebody can read the next one if they like.
I got you. There are many scriptures in the Bible that describe praise dancing. Let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises into him with the timbrel and harp. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his people. He will beautify the meek with salvation. That's Psalm 149, 3 and 4.
So, yeah, like I said, y'all want to get a little deeper. Thank you, Mike, for that. And you'll get a little deeper in that. Somebody want to read the next one as they like?
Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Praise be the Lord. Psalm 154 to 6.
Amen.
All right, there you go. Everything, like I said, everything that have breath, let's praise the Lord with it. You know, dance with, you know, instruments. And, you know, I mean, I think Brother Mike, you know, has a tambourine. And, you know, like, you know, Minister Brown, like Minister Brown always said, that, you know, try to get some musical people in here. You know what I mean? But the Lord knows. God's time, we know that. It'll happen. So, all right, you want to read on?
I just say something real quick. You know, one thing I'm seeing from this lesson about dancing is that it's all about the purpose behind why you're dancing.
Okay.
When we started off this morning, we were talking about judges. The men were told to go out there and hide in the bushes and wait for the women to dance so that they could find them a wife. Sort of like back when I was young, you go to the club on Saturday night. Because the way they dancing in there, that'll provoke you to want to find a wife.
I got you.
But the way, I think we see what happened, right? There's no ring on my finger. I think we see what happened. But that was the whole purpose of it.
Yep.
That's the whole reason why that you dress the way you dress. When you go out there, you know what you're looking for. When you go out there, you know what goes on in the clubs. There's a reason why they serve alcohol. There's a reason why these things happen the way they happen. And everybody almost has the same story. Because the purpose behind it is because you're looking for a little bit of action. Okay? Same way they did in Judges. But as we go through the rest of these scriptures and we talk about dancing for the Lord, well, there's a different purpose behind it, because now your outward expression of dance is reflecting how you feel about him on the inside. And so that's why, like, you know, Unc was talking about, we have a band in here and we get going. You know, when Pastor would bring, you know, Carlos up here and Little D, and he banging on the drums, and Carlos is on the organ, and we got, you ready to break out. You ready to dance. You ready to dance because it gets you going. Now, you're not in here the same way dancing that you're same way you would on a Saturday night.
No.
But your dance is different. Yeah. Amen.
That's a different
dance. Your dance
is
different. There's nobody dropping it on the altar. Okay? The two don't even go together.
No, it don't.
There's nobody backing it up on the altar. Okay? But at the same time, there's nobody praise dancing in the club.
Right. That's the difference.
So there's a different kind of dance, and it all goes behind the purpose.
Well, amen. Thanks for that.
Love to do is dance.
Yeah.
They used to call me the dancing machine.
Yeah, I know.
I used to love dancing. I used to go to cabarets. Everybody having a cabaret, I'm there and I'm on the floor, probably the first one on the floor. And I said all that to say, I still like doing the line dancing, and I love walking. So I consider the dancing that I do exercising, and I don't back it up like it's hot.
Yeah.
But there have been times if I'm somewhere and I was dancing with my husband, yes, I did back it up like it was hot.
Yeah.
And I actually met my husband in a club.
Yeah.
So it's one of those things that I still enjoy dancing, but now it's a difference because you can't go out there and dance like you used to dance.
Yeah, yeah.
Because of who you are.
You feel guilty.
You feel guilty.
Yeah,
exactly.
I know
so
I do.
So you're not going to go out there and do it. Do I still slide if I go somewhere and somebody got music on? I'll still do the electric slide. But again, I consider myself sliding for the Lord and not for man.
Amen.
So
Amen.
I just thank God for this lesson today on dancing, because now I can actually dance for him and not for the world. And I never danced to be seen. I just like to dance. I actually wanted to be a dancer at a young age, but I got scoliosis, so that kind of stopped me from doing a lot of moving forward with my dancing. I tried to do, I'm going to say this real quick, and I'm going to stop. Last night, I was asking Chesley about some exercising, and I went down, and I got back up. I'm like, oh, no. I already feel this already. This ain't going to happen. This is not going to happen. So I just thank God that he gives us wisdom.
Amen.
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 And I just want to say about the dancing, me and my husband had won a dancing contest at one of his job's Christmas parties.
It was dirty dancing.
Cash prize.
Yeah, I forgot about that, babe. And hey, guess who got the money, though?
I just want to say one more thing about the lesson. For the couples in here that do love to dance and that dance with each other, remember that. When things start not to go right, when you start having problems with each other, put the song on.
Yeah.
Start to dance. It'll remind you to bring you back together. When you can bond over, you put on little Frankie Beverly, whatever it may be, and you start to dance, little Teddy P, whatever it is, but it brings you back because that's what can keep you together.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen. Oh, yeah, I just want to just add on. It's been a while because I wanted to do a daughter and father dance with my daughter, and be careful what you ask for. So finally, don't worry, I call her Smooth, my daughter. Don't worry, Dad ain't going to embarrass you, you know what I mean? So we're looking forward to it. Yeah. I mean, I'm looking forward to it, you know what I mean? And we're going to have a good time. We're going to have a good time. So, all right, let's read on. I ain't got that much time. All right. You want to read? Or you got to get the mic. It's recording. So, everybody liking this? Bible study right for now is a good one. I tell you, that dance, it brings everybody.
Jesus said, and he lifted up his eyes on his disciples and said, blessed be ye poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are ye that hunger now, for ye shall be filled. Blessed are ye that weep now, for ye shall laugh. Blessed are ye when men shall hate you, and when they shall separate you from their company, and shall reproach you, and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake. Rejoice ye in that day, and leap for joy, for behold, your reward is great in heaven. For in the like manner did their fathers unto the prophets. Luke 6:20-23.
Wow. But see, there y'all go again. You know what I mean? About dancing. There's so much involved with dancing, you know what I mean? It rewards you in heaven. You know what I mean? So I don't know if we could do the electric slide up there, it says, but we'll figure that out when we get there, I guess, right? You know what I mean? All right, amen. All right. Rejoice. That's what it says. There you go.
There you go. So, we're going to be doing some dancing up there. Yes, we are, in Jesus' name.
All right. All right.
Oh, yeah, we're going to have some count. We're going to have some count. What? Yeah, David could dance. Yeah, according to the way, like, according to hear what David said, you know what I mean? They could cut a rug or two, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? All right, let me proceed. All right, I'm going to go. All right, the next. Would you feel like dancing if you were hate, if you hated, reject, and slandered? Well, I guess that is implying, like you said, people in the clubs, of course. Of course you're going to be rejected. You know, you're in these clubs like that, doing what you, you know, provocative dancing and all that, and that's not acceptable in God's eyes, you know. So if the only reason people dance today were to praise God, there would be no need for God to ever be displeased with dancing. However, dancing often has a lot more to do with self and selfish desires and thought through them it has to do with God. Dancing is a controversial issues in church. Some Christians advise that dancing be prohibited altogether. But I don't know what kind of church you know what I mean? Because I know our Lord and our God, you know, he loved, you know, prayer dances, you know what I mean?
That you have showing. Some of your old-time churches that don't want that kind of dancing going on in their church. I mean, White Rock is one of them. They to the old, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And praise the Lord. And I know one time, I believe he's gone now, but I had one of the ministers had said to me, I was sitting behind him, and he turned around, he told me that I was clapping too loud and talking too loud. Yes, he did.
But that's you,
yes,
though. That's
did.
Annie.
Yes, he did. And I told him, you can't tell me how to praise my God.
That's right.
You can do whatever you want to do, but you move, but you can't tell me how to praise my God.
Well, that's what the Lord said.
There you go. So, yeah, when you get people like
the Lord
that,
says
that was
shout.
In church, okay, you're going to tell me how to pray. And I told him, no. You can't tell me how to praise my God. You don't know what I've been through.
Exactly.
You don't know my story.
Right.
So because you don't know my story, you don't tell me how to praise my God.
No.
That's like the song Shirley Caesar had wrote about shouting John. He said, if you don't want to shout, don't hinder me.
Right.
Because he's going to praise God because God brought him through many things. And that's as far as myself. I'm going to praise God whether people like it or not. Amen.
All right.
Say something.
I have learned that praise will confuse the enemy when somebody done tried to attack you, done talked about you, scandalized your name. And they see that I'm still praising God. They might look at me and see, you must be crazy. Well, you know what? I'm crazy for the Lord. And I have peace and comfort that you don't know something about. Amen.
Amen. All right. All right, let's go. I don't have that. All right, let's move on. I don't have that much time to go. So I'm going to finish reading this. Perhaps this is something for you to work out. Perhaps this is something for you to work out between yourself and God. If you have an especially strong tendency towards lust or inappropriate thoughts about the opposite sex, it'd be best to avoid situations where you may be dancing closely or could get carried away. Well, that's going back to what Minister Brandon was saying, you know, in the clubs. So that's, you know, God don't like that kind of dancing, you know what I mean? But, and also what my sister-in-law said, you know what I mean? You know, back there, we didn't know, you know, we thought that was a norm, you know, dropping it like it's hot and all that, you know what I mean? And backing that thing up, you know? So it is fornication.
Yeah, I just wanted to add one thing to that, because one year we were celebrating my birthday down in Ocean City, Maryland. Who were we at? was that place?
Secrets.
At Secrets.
Oh, don't, babe, don't
and
do it.
It was getting a little, you know what, it was getting a little crazy up in there because I was on the floor dancing. The next thing you know I'm saying was between two women. And I'm like, oh, no, that's it. That's it. That's why you got to be careful. You know what I mean? You got to be careful. You have to really be careful.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. And I got kicked out. We got kicked out.
We got kicked out because of him.
Well, that's what brother is about. Memories, right? Yeah, it's about memories. There you go. The end results, we're dancing with God. Dancing for the Lord. All right, let's move on. However, if you're able to control yourself and enjoy good music and tasteful dancing, maybe this is a permission for you. Well, there you go. That's the good side. You know what I mean? Like my minister said, you know what I mean? You get into a little, you know, depression mode, put the, you know, Marvin Gaye on, and even if you just stand there listening to it, some Luther, you know what I'm saying? And you know what I mean? Get back into the groove, get that feeling back, you know what I mean? So, dancing is good. Dancing is good. All right, even more. All right. Regardless of whether you think dancing is okay or not, there are certain types of dancing that are never okay. Here we go. Clothes bumping and grinding and other dancing that mix sex and is never okay. And it's weird how we just talk about hair popped up, right? Yeah.
You know what? It's something that you say that about the bumping and grinding, because we all know R. Kelly came out with that song. I don't see nothing wrong with a little bumping grind.
Yeah, but look at him now, again, serving 100 years.
Exactly. Look at him now. But again, that's how the world wants to proceed everything. You don't see nothing wrong with a little bumping grind. But God sees a lot wrong with it.
A lot.
But you know what?
Strangers. That little leaven. Mm-hmm. It explodes. Explodes. Mm-hmm.
And it grows. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
All right, let's move on. Everybody getting it, huh? Everybody getting it. That's good. Good stuff. All right. This type of movement stirs lustful desires and invite temptation. Rubbing bodies together to excite sexual desires is an effort, is an affront to God, who created dancing so that. Let me read that again. Who create dancing so that we could praise him with our bodies. I like that. You see how to end it. You know what I mean? That's a good thing. Pray about it. And God will reveal it to you if it is his will for you to dance. All right. So that was the end of that. Like I said.
Excuse me, Brother Manny. I just wanted to say that, too, because it just came back to my mind. I was talking to my niece. I know that me and the girls, we want to get together. We want to do a praise dance. But I want to talk. I asked my niece about it, and I said I wanted to talk to Geneva because she's over the praise dancing. Mm-hmm. And I thought about it some time ago and over the years, and I said, well, you know what? Because I couldn't be that dancer back then because of my scoliosis, now I can dance for the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to talk to Geneva about it because I was asking my niece about choreographing a praise dance, you know, that I can do. And I know that me and the girls, we were talking about doing an old lady dance. This was last year before old lady gang dance, what Sadie had brought it to our attention. But I like the idea of the dance, and I'm glad that you brought it back up so I can talk to Geneva and talk to the pastor, because I would like to do that. I would love to dance for the Lord. Amen. Now that, you know, I can't, you know, we're never too old to dance, put it
never,
that way.
Never.
So this blessing today is great, because good. Now I don't have to dance for the world. I can dance for the Lord.
Amen. All right, let me proceed. I got about 5 minutes. I'm going to do the prayer, closing prayer. And that says, Dear God, I repent if I have displeased you by dancing. I cannot say when I dance, I show often that others, I show others that I was a Christian. I cannot say that while I danced, others saw Jesus in me. I repent of dancing. I repent of having done anything that would not be a testimony to others that Jesus is foremost in my life. I ask you to forgive me for not keeping my body untouched and pure in your sight. I pray for forgiveness if I have caused another person to question my morals. I do not need to dance or to have peace and happiness. I do not need to dance to feel fulfilled and happy. I do need you in my life. Please come into my heart and forgive me. I will not dance in that way again, because I do not believe that it is best for my life or my testimony. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And thank you for the opportunity. All right. Remember, get your dance on. Amen, amen, amen. And we want to thank Unc for that lesson this morning. Amen, on dancing. And you know, as the ushers are getting ready to come around now for the Sunday school, I just want to take a quick moment, give a shout out to Pastor E, because that was all his idea. We used to give out the topics to the deacons and Unc and everybody before they would teach Sunday school on the Sundays, you know, where Pastor E didn't teach. And he said, let the Lord direct their path, because then, you know, they'll get used to working for him. And, you know, that was such a good idea. I have a preview. I'm not going to give out any spoilers of some of the lessons that are to come.
Yes, sir.
But let me tell y'all, these are some mighty powerful lessons. And if y'all thought dancing was good this morning, y'all ain't seen nothing yet.
Yeah.
Amen. All righty, y'all, come on down.
That's
Thank you this morning for the Sunday school lesson that you gave us this morning of dancing, and pretty allow us to dance with you, Father God.
We thank you for the offering that we received. We pray that you bless everybody that gave, Father God. May they have given with a cheerful heart. We pray for the leadership in this church that they'll do everything that you commanded us to do with your money. For it is in Jesus' name that we pray this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I just want to say one more thing before we close out and have our 10-minute break and we get started by 11 o'clock. So we've seen the older generation, how they get down with they dance. They came in here. We talked about my generation with the bumping and the grinding. Now, y'all don't want to see the generation behind me come up here and dance, okay? I'm talking about Ivory generation. They dance like they some gangbangers. I said, what is going on in here? All right, y'all go ahead, y'all. We'll be back in 10 minutes. Oh, yeah, I'm talking like we on TV somewhere. Yeah, we're 10 minutes.
Music Ministry.